Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial is up 370. We get the NASDAQ up 115. S&Ps are up 28. You get gold up 720, trading 1350. We get silver up 17 at 15 even. And we have our man, Mr. Rob McEwen, up, who's the chairman and chief owner of McEwen Mine. McEwen Mining trades on the NYSE as MUX. The low for the year is 123. The high is 5252. Rob McEwen, welcome back to TFNN.
Hello, Tom.
Thanks for coming, man. Appreciate it.
Glad to be on.
So,
thank you.
The volatility in the gold market, we have that. Let's talk about McEwen Mining, and let's talk about what you're doing right now, what we're doing in the future.
All right. Well, the first part of the year it's been exciting. In the first quarter, we had some operational challenges, which are now behind us. We started, declared commercial production on May 23rd of our newest mine, our fourth mine. It's the Gold Bar Mine in Nevada. It's an open pit heap leach gold mine. So we're quite excited that that's come on stream. We have a large exploration program both in Nevada, where we're looking to expand our oxide ore reserves and look for deeper high-grade sulfide ores, much like they're finding 25 miles up the road at Barrick's property, Cortez Hills, Four Mile, and Gold Rush deposits, where there's a cluster of about 50 million ounces. We're on the same trend, we have similar geology, and we're going to be drilling deeper to see if some of that wonderful gold that they have sits down below us as well.
And folks, Rob's website, it's McEwenMining.com. If you come over to it, you're going to see it's pretty extensive with a huge amount of information, and it's showing a 3D view, which is pretty cool, of all the projects and as they're taking place. So, you know, the gold business in general, okay, always, you know, we have the political atmosphere inside it. You got the ore atmosphere, can you get it out of the ground? And then, of course, we got, you know, what is the dollar doing? So when we talk politics, you're in some great jurisdictions.
Absolutely. We're in Nevada, which is one of the richest gold areas in the world. And we're also in Timmins, in Canada, which is a long history of over 100 years of producing gold. And within the region, there's been over 200 million ounces of gold produced.
Pretty amazing. So yeah. when we look at the company, Rob, right, I see that you're saying that we have gold, we have silver, we have copper, right?
Yes.
And the mixes, where do the mix come in? How does the mix work?
We would, about 30% of our production would be silver. The balance is gold. And the copper is a deposit that we have. It's quite large. It's about, when you take the inferred and resources, it's up to 30 billion pounds of copper.
Amazing.
So it's located in Argentina, and it's a project we're looking to see if we can joint venture to develop it.
Nice. Now, what do you think, you know, like, I think the first time I met, oh my God, you know, I'm not even going to say how long ago for both of us, but we met a long time ago when I started the Gold Report. And when I started the Gold Report, of course, gold was at 282. And, you know, it's interesting. So I thought the exact same thing. We always talk about the aspect, okay, well, the dollar was going to go to hell in a handbag. But the reality is that all the rest of the currencies kind of went to hell in a handbag. The dollar's still hanging up here. And I know that a lot of us are scratching our head like, okay, so, the dollar's staying strong, but yet now we are getting some real traction once again in gold.
That's so right.
How do you think that shakes out?
Taking a lot longer than I thought as well, Tom, that gold right now, or the dollar, is driving the price of gold.
Yes.
And the dollar's been the place where most of the money in the world has wanted to go lately. Gold's been going up in better than 70 different currencies around the world, but in the dollar, it's been held in a pretty tight range. We are seeing recently with concerns about trade wars and some of the conflicts going on around the world. We've seen an improving tone in gold. And somewhere along the way, I'm quite convinced people are going to say, gold's been beaten up. this is an area that we should put some money into. The rest of the market's been running very strongly. It's delivered some great returns. Maybe it's time to take some money out of there because the upside potential in gold seems to be greater than the upside potential in the broad market.
No, I agree. I think, you know, what's intriguing here, folks, and Rob, is that this run here really seems like the run in 2016. And what happened there, you know, we had a really nice run, folks. It was really, when gold runs, it likes to run fast. But that was a real run. And, you know, we'll see. Bottom line is if we take out this consolidation. This consolidation's been out there a long period of time.
Yes.
You know, and it looks to me that we actually do have buyers in there. Okay, so interest rates, right? I mean, years ago, folks, what would end up happening is that analysts would say all day long on Wall Street, you don't want to own gold because it doesn't pay any interest. Well, guess what? We know that now, at least the gold market doesn't charge you money to buy it. Right?
Yes.
You know, so, I mean, it seems that it's all going with us right now. I mean, this interest rate structure is pretty amazing. I mean, we had the 10-year today go down to 2.01, and, you know, it backed off. But guess what? It only took another 3 or 4 hours that it's going right back down to, you know, 2.2 right now.
Yeah, I mean, it's so difficult for people to survive with those types of interest rates around.
Yes.
People are being pushed into riskier environment investments to try to get their money to work for them. And here you have gold benefits from the lower interest rate.
Yeah, there's no doubt. You know, so when we look at the structure, the gold market in general, is there more supply than demand, or more demand than supply, like going forward the next few years? How do you look at that? Because what does happen, folks, is that when we stay at a low price, well, it's harder to open all these mines. So I'm just curious what you're viewing on that is, Rob.
I'd say the annual supply is shrinking as a result of very little money being spent on exploration over the last, well, since the end of 2011.
That's a long time. Yep.
And regulations have, in most countries, have increased, so it takes longer to permit a mine. And the mines that are being brought on tend to be larger, so they're more capital intensive, take longer to build, take longer to pay back.
Yes.
And that's all shrinking the supply of gold coming into the market space.
Yeah, it's gonna be interesting watching this shake out. And of course, tomorrow we have the Chairman Powell, but it looked like Mario Draghi took his power away today when he said over in Europe that, hey, listen, we're gonna do just about anything to make sure that we get some type of growth. You know, so gonna be wild watching this shake out. There's no doubt. Well, listen, Rob, it's always a pleasure having you on. Look forward to having you on again. It's McEwen Mining, folks. I'm Mr. Rob McEwen. He's the chairman and the chief owner, which you don't see, by the way, in companies in general. Rob, you have a great one, a safe one. Appreciate you coming on. Look forward to having you again.
Thank you, Tom. Gold is money.
Gold? That's a fact. Gold is money. Have a great one, man. Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Okay, bye-bye.